So we will now start the tutorial. So for a disk, what is the mass moment of inertia about the center?
Half pi omega square, sorry, half mr square.
M r square over 2, I'm just giving that, I'm not deriving it. But you can see the, I think there is a, so if you look at the mass moment of inertia about the center, right? About the z axis it is rotating, so what is the mass moment of inertia? I have m r square over 2. So just note this down and then we can solve this problem, okay? By the way, anyone could tell me that whether we have to really take into account gravity effect or not in this problem? So we don't have to, you can try to solve it by first considering the static equilibrium, because as we can see that there will be a static equilibrium configuration when this spring is going to stretch and this is actually coming down. We can start the problem from there, but ultimately if we really look at the oscillation from the static equilibrium configuration, your equation of motion will not have any g on it. Okay, so gravity will not come into the picture if I consider the static equilibrium configuration, oscillation from the static equilibrium. So that configuration you can choose just along the line AB. So line AB we can just say that, okay, it is my static equilibrium configuration, okay, and just give it a small rotation theta. So it's a two line problem basically. Yes, why not? We have a spring, no? No, it is rotating, it is rotating along with the disk. This bar is rotating along with the disk. No, that is attached to the disk. That is firmly attached to the disk. So that's a good point. The bar is firmly attached to the disk and it is rotating. Otherwise, it will collapse immediately if there is a pin. Yes. The whole idea is to draw the free body diagram very quickly and solve, that's all. Just draw the free body diagram, get the equation of motion. So time period of vibration omega n, anyone got? Omega or capital T, anyone? No, I have numbers, no, just use the numbers. Equals to how much, please? No. Yes? No, it answer is 12.6. Did anyone get that? It's not that difficult, you just, there is a, this force you find out, no? If the rotation is r theta, so rotation is theta, then we have the displacement r theta, right? And then that k r theta is the force, and that moment of that is k r square theta. And then from this side, from the rod we are getting, right? M l square over 3, that will be added with the m r square over 2. I at least am not expecting one answer, because we have quiz also afterwards. 12, anyone got? 12.6 is the answer. Yes. So we'll move on to the solution. So here, what we have done, we have taken the IB directly here. So that will have two components. One is the M L square over 3 coming from the bar, right? Because this bar, if I look at the inertia force about this rotational inertia force, then we are going to have ml square over 3, right? And from the disk itself, we have mr square over 2, okay? And from the spring, we have basically kr square. So this is the equation of motion that we are going to get. And omega n is going to be this. Oh, that spring, you see here, what is the displacement we are getting here? So if I move the system, no? So this is r theta in small displacement. So spring force is kr theta. We take the moment about A, so that is kr square theta, kr theta multiplied by r. Clear? See, remember in the mass, here you can also show the mass, you know, at the lumped mass here, with a translatory force and the inertia force, that can also be done. But ultimate effect will come here, that is ml square over 3. Okay, so in that problem. So ultimately, we have the time period of oscillation, that is 0.496. Maximum velocity at end A. Remember how we calculate that? We know the solution for theta, theta 0 is given. What is theta 0? 18 divided by 900. So that's my theta 0.
Sir?
Yes.
Can you go to the previous slide? Sir, in this slide, from D. Lambert's principle, in this you had written, but in this mass of rod is not taken care.
No, I'll do this here, right here. Because what is shown here is directly taking the IB there, so we can actually do this. See, first we make a lumped mass here, right? And then we show that it is being rotated here, so this should be L over 2 theta. Okay, so that will be M L over 2 theta double dot, right? Along with that, I will have an inertia force to equilibrate this, so direction will be this. Okay, so this is the mass center is rotating, so that value I know, ml square over 12 theta double dot. Okay. Then remember, I can draw this thing, in a different way. It was shown directly there. So here I am getting the moment of inertia of the disk itself, right? So disk is rotating about its center. So here I can show that this will be M capital R square by 2 theta double dot. Okay? And then I have K R theta. So that's the complete free body diagram we can draw. Now remember, these two forces, that translatory inertia force and the mass moment of inertia, so these two, if you are trying to take the moment about this, ultimately become what? This will become equivalent system if you look at, right? That is going to be m l square by 3. Okay, so it will be ultimately m l square over 3 if you take a moment about this here, and this is anyway going to add to that. Okay? So ultimately we are going to get ml square 3 that will be coming from the bar about this point plus mr square over 2. Okay? So effectively I can show like this. So ultimately what I had shown there, that okay, I have a IB. Okay, and that IB was equals to, if you go step by step, that is actually m l by 2 theta double dot. So this is theta double dot IB. That multiplied by l over 2 plus m l square over 12 theta double dot, right? Plus m r square over 2 theta double dot. So ultimately what we get is m l square over 3 theta double dot plus m r square over 2. Is that clear? Now? So you can simply show like this also. But it is always better to, you know, go to this mode, because what we are doing is from the beginning, this is the right approach. So the approach is very simple. As such, we are just looking at, you can connect this very easily with the virtual work, that all I am doing here is that I am giving it a displacement, right? Which is small, comparable. Okay, the both the cases we kept doing this one, that we have to find the displacement at various points. In virtual work, you are just doing the work done, right? In this case, I am just saying take a moment. You can also solve this using virtual work, as we have seen. Any question on this? Clear? So next problem, therefore, just a little variation. The problem statement is clear. There is no friction about O, so that is N equals all the time ignored. And we just have to displace the system, that means we have to rotate a system by a small amount. You can give it in any direction you want. It's a single degree of freedom system. Or is it a single degree of freedom system or not? It will be, because ultimately this mass is going to come down depending on how much I rotate. So they are connected, interlinked, okay? I have it in little different form, but you are correct, yes. Yes. So as such, it's a very simple problem. And remember, you can always exercise this, whether the gravity is going to, you know, affect it or not. So this is a very good exercise if you really have to take the gravity into account or not. Okay. So I will again. I'll just ignore the gravity effect part, but we can show that, you know, how the individual things looks like. So actually, if you can consider this as a static problem also first to begin with, so what happens due to this mass, there will be a rotation theta st, right? So what is that theta st? Can we calculate that? So that can be calculated very easily. You may or may not want to take two free bodies, but we do so because there are indeed two bodies, so we can detach them. So just this spring is going to take care of the mass here, okay, the spring force. So ultimately what will happen, this is my static equilibrium consideration. If we do, then we take the moment about O, right? So the static displacement, or rather static rotation, can be defined as this. Okay. So make sure to substitute TST equals to MG. So that's my static configuration I have. Then we give additional rotation. So now the system is moving from the static equilibrium configuration, right, by an amount theta. Then again, you redo the problem. Everything has to be, you know, recalculated. When I go to static equilibrium configuration, then I give it a small oscillation. Just take a look how the free bodies looks like. What are the forces in the free bodies? So that is my UAM for the block. Remember, what is happening? Now we are in dynamic, right? Due to the dynamic effect, this mass will now experience the inertia force, translator inertia force, that is equals to mr theta double dot. Remember, since I have detached it, so there is an increment in the, therefore, tension in that cable, right? So tst plus t, so that t is the new tension, right? Because we know there is inertia force already, so t has to, you know, change. It can't be tst, okay? So as I'm saying, you may want to detach it or you don't detach it. It is up to you, Okay, you may not want to detach that mass at all. So ultimately, you see, if I do this exercise, just go through it, very simple. So for this mass, small mass mg, I have this equation of motion established. Okay? And then you do the equation of motion for the disks, right? So that will be sum of moment about its point O equals to zero. Ultimately, you can prove that gravity will not play any role. Okay, so there will be a part cancel. This TST, MG, this equation is in turn going to be carried forward and it will cancel. So ultimate equation will become this, right? And some of you have got this, right? Now probably you have done so without taking the gravity effect. That is fine, because indeed I can prove that gravity will not play any role in this problem. Okay? So just look at it, you know, these are exercises we give to understand that whether, you know, gravity effect is coming into play or not. We can also do this without considering the gravity effect. That is what all of you have done. If from the very beginning I don't say mg is there, you see, I have dropped the mg here. I don't have mg now, that is dropped. I can solve it. So I have shown you now both approaches. One is to, you know, just look at the static deflection, then from there we start the motion. And there are problems where it may affect, there are problems where it may not affect. And it will be affected, gravity will affect it as long as you have an inverted pendulum or a pendulum type problem. Okay, that is pinned about point A somewhere, in a vertical bar going like this. But in all of these cases, we are not going to get any kind of gravity effect. Is that approach clear? Again, you may see this one, as I said, since there are two free bodies, therefore I have detached it. But it is not necessary. You can simply keep, just say m r theta double dot and don't take into account t. That can also be done. So then you just say, okay, m r theta double dot is directly acting on this body in the direction of the cable, okay? And you take the moment of that thing about O. Any question on this? Clear? Yes.
I did two, both the forces in the spring are towards the right, left toward the right.
Which one?
Theta, theta.
See, if you rotate it by a theta clockwise, right?
Clockwise.
One is compressed.
Yes.
So if compressed, then how it gives the force back to this? That way, right? Then other one is in the tension.
Yes.
Now that what it does? That actually pulls? That pulls. So ultimately you have compression as well as you have a pull. So both are in the same directions. Okay. Any question? Done? Now last problem is going to be interesting. We want to determine the P that will cause the natural frequency of the rod approach to zero for small oscillators. It's a very, very nice problem. Again, it's concerns actually stability of the system. Okay, so you will be able to find a P where T tends to infinity, time period tends to infinity or omega n equals to zero. Now we can show statically also using the potential energy approach that if the P is less than that, then it will never be stable, okay, at that theta equals to zero. This problem is just two lines problem, and I would expect that more of you get involved and just give me the answer. Get the equations of motion first, and set omega equals to zero. Or T tends to infinity, whatever way. So you have to make sure that in this problem, gravity will enter, okay? It's an inverted pendulum, okay? So we see that. So gravity has to be taken into account from the very beginning. You can't ignore gravity. And we have solved a similar problem. Remember, there was a bar with two springs and attached mass was there, so gravity was that there, okay? Yes?
80 kilonewton.
No, no. It's a very large value we are going to get. What was that? You said kilonewton, right? Not 15. 50 is not the answer. Anyone? Just draw the free body diagram clearly. What are the forces, by the way? 34 kilonewton is the answer, yes. So just take a look at the free body diagram here quickly. Now here again, you know, I have taken here this as equivalent moment that is coming from the rod. So this is ML square over ML square theta, okay? So ultimately we have this force right here. There is another spring force, both should be in the same directions. If I oscillate the system this way, then remember there is a compressive force in this spring, so that will act towards left. This will also be tensile, this will act towards left, so there are two forces. Just calculate the displacement properly. Then we have the P. That P will create a torque about this, mg will create a torque about this, and ultimately there is a distributed mass here, so that will be m l square by 3 is this. You can also lump it here, no issue. If you lump it, then there is a translational force and there is a rotation about the wound center, right? So that can be done that way also, but see, ultimately I am transferring the effect here already to here, and that we have already learned. Right, m l square over 3 will always be the inertia force about the pin. Okay, is that steps clear, everyone? Okay, so ultimately as you got the answer, so roughly 34 kilonewton, 33970 newton, roughly 34 kilonewton is the answer. Now we can do a very, you know, good exercise here. You know what I would ask you to do? Can you use potential energy approach and show that theta equals to 0 is a solution, okay? And P less than this will be the solution where it is stable. See, as soon as P is greater than this, it is going to be unstable, even at theta equals to 0. So ultimately start from potential energy. Forget about the dynamic, okay? Suppose at omega equals to 0, we already said. So now it's a static problem. I have a P, right? So can we show that for P less than this, system is stable, otherwise it is unstable? Is that clear? Using potential energy, right? That was done yesterday. How do you do that? Same approach. Now there is no dynamic, there is no inertia force. All I am saying, now the bar is straight right here and determine the stability, that's all. At theta equals to 0 configuration, determine the stability of the bar, whether it is stable or whether it is unstable, period. Can we do that? So what would be the potential energy of the system? All of these are actually going to be, you know, there, except for that you drop this one. You can also do it in a finite rotation, fine. Okay, sine theta, cosine theta can come to play. But small deflection, you know, your potential energy, you just have to put together what is the potential energy. So that will be half k delta square for the spring, then you have the force, right, and you have the mg, so all of this needs to be taken into account, okay? So I'll show that quickly. So there is no virtual work, there is a mistake here. So this is, we are just talking about potential energy, so can we see that this is the expression for potential energy? If we can get that's the energy, you know, expression, then problem is solved. Then what do we do? dv d theta equals to 0. we can actually show that theta equals to 0 is indeed an equilibrium configuration, right, first. And then we check for d2v d theta 2 greater than 0, right, what is p, okay. So the next step would be, if you get that potential energy, that's it. So dv d theta we do, right? And ultimately see, you have two cases here. And we can show that theta equals to 0 is indeed an equilibrium condition, right? Then question is whether it is stable or unstable. So we substitute, we do the d2v d theta 2 greater than 0. And for theta equals to 0, we get this expression back. So this is the expression which says that p should be less than this. So I have not incorporated all the algebraic quantities so far. It was done in terms of algebraic quantities. Now let's put the numbers here. So if I put the numbers, you see the problem? Okay, so p less than this, it can only be stable. See, what happened in dynamic case, with that p, it has actually gone to infinite oscillation, right? That means it can't come back. As soon as, see, this is actually limiting condition, that p equals to that is the limiting condition, it can't come back. So what we have shown through potential energy, that as long as p less than this, it will be stable. As soon as, let's say, p equals to 34 kilonewton, actually it is going to collapse, it is unstable. So we can link. So what I have done today, essentially, I have also told you that virtual work, why it is necessary. I have ultimately told you that why potential energy is also coming into play to really do certain amount, you know, certain dynamic problems. Okay, so everything is interlinked. And as long as we feel that, okay, in civil engineering, we really don't consider those rectilinear motion, curvilinear motions. See, ultimately, we don't, you know, use the problems involved really lot of, you know, curvilinear, rectilinear, impulse, momentum type of stuff. What we really focus on the vibration for civil engineers. In fact, mechanical engineers, they have lot of problem for vibrations. Aerospace, lot of vibrations problem. So we really in dynamics, what we thought of doing in IIT, and as you have seen that all the other things that we have done is very exhaustive. Okay, and therefore we just made a common platform of all the disciplines, and we tried to say, okay, let us try to at least tell, you know, students that we can derive the equations of motion for spring mass system type of problems, which is applicable to many disciplines. And ultimately, we are able to give a, you know, some kind of flavor that, okay, we can link those problems with the, you know, stability, unstability. We can also do the virtual work. Instead of saying that moment equals to zero, can we use the virtual work to solve the equations of motion? Okay. Is that all? Any question? So we'll just do the, you know, but we can definitely discuss. If you have different requirement, we can try to see if that can be fit in into the main workshop for the dynamics, okay? But for statics, even we have to think whether we are going to be so exhaustive in the, you know, kind of in the main workshop. But we felt that, you know, whatever we do at a great depth. I mean, that is what most important than just doing it bits and pieces, okay?